Hello, everyone. Reverend Dell here. And I use that term very loosely, the reverend thing, the minister, the chaplain. I use that term very, very loosely because I've abandoned systematic theologies to follow the Lord Jesus Christ as he instructed me to do after my near-death experience when I was trying to find my niche in the world for serving him. You serve him simply by listening and abiding in the Lord Jesus Christ. And I will call this video today, You Can't Put God in a Box. And this is what men try to do. They try to take command and control of the Lord Jesus Christ, religious men with religious zeal, just like the scribes and Pharisees did in the days that Christ walked the earth. They were Jesus' worst enemies, these religious scholars. And it's the same today, I dare say. I told a pastor, my pastor, and I say that very loosely also, because my pastor, my shepherd, is the Lord Jesus Christ himself. He abides in me, and I walk in him, and he shows me all truth. If you put an antichrist, which is an alternative to the Lord Jesus Christ, between you and God, you're headed down the road to spiritual death. You must follow the Lord in spirit and in truth. If you have a love for the truth, that you might be saved. Satan's church system strives to replace another human being for his place with Jesus Christ. And people fall into this trap. They call it church. They call it fellowship. Forsake not the assembly. You know, all these kind of things that we're familiar with. But the actual, an assembly, as an engineer, I can tell you that an assembly is what is designed by an engineer. The engineer, the doctor, whatever, the great healer, the great physician, the great engineer is the Lord God of Israel. And he is made manifest through the Lord Jesus Christ. In salvation by grace. But the thing is, and I was raised a Calvinist, we must follow the Lord. If we don't follow the Lord, we will be given over to what we love more than him, 2 Thessalonians. And this is what I see happening. It's tragic. There's so many people in the church system think they're going to go to heaven when they die. But actually, if they're not with him now in spirit and in truth, they won't be with him when their bodies pack up. Excuse me. I don't prepare sermons. I don't prepare notes when I do my videos. I just simply speak from the heart. That's because I want to allow the truth of God to be manifest through me as he gives me the words to speak and as he gives me the ability to see. If I start writing sermon notes from the Bible like most of your ministers do, I find that really something's lost. You know, as a minister, I can tell you that you can order sermons. You can order how to do Bible books. So, you know, how to teach people, how to do this, how to do that. But that's all walking in the flesh. That's all walking independent of the Lord Jesus Christ. No, the ones of us who actually have him, the genuine ecclesia, the genuine, God's elect, God's the one that God has started to work in, will show us all things in his spirit. Jesus Christ promised this. Is Jesus Christ a liar? No, he's not. But you know, nobody's got the nads to say, and excuse my rough language, but to say that they really don't believe them, that they want to do it themselves. They want to take command and control God themselves. Oh, we have to spread the gospel. You know, where it says in the scriptures to the 11 original disciples, Jesus said, which he made apostles, go and spread the gospel to the four corners of the earth. He was talking specifically to these 11 men. But it's like people that read a war novel that have never been in battle. And they say, oh, yeah, that's talking to me. Yeah, I see what it's saying. I've never been in battle. I've never actually even been in the military. But that's talking to me because I read it in a book. That's how people look at the scriptures that don't know the Lord. You have to know the Lord and you have to move with the Lord as he leads, not independent of him. And I told a minister years ago, my pastor, I said, you loosely years ago, you can't put God in a box. The man tried to change the subject desperately as I went into his office in the church. He desperately wanted to change the subject. And I didn't understand as to why. It's because actually I was attacking him. I didn't realize it. I thought he was a man of God. And I said, you know, you can't put God in the box. He won't be able to show you anything. I finally forced a doctrinal position, my theology on him. And it's funny because I think he was a broad roader. He would hear the things of God, having started with the Lord Jesus Christ, having gone to seminary, you know, formal seminary. But it's a heart issue. Are you going to continue to follow the Lord Jesus Christ in spirit and truth, or are you going to take control of God? You know, we have a Bible, we have theology, we have doctrine, we can do this independent of God. That's what most churches do, because they won't have a love for the truth that they might be saved. That's right, that they might be saved. And most are handed over to strong delusion. Excuse my appearance. Sometimes I look rough. Most of the time I look rough in these videos because right now it's 6 a.m. I don't get up and shave and put the nice coat and tie on and have my Bible with me and say things like, let's see, what was it? One of the things that the guy says on YouTube, can you believe that, or something to that effect. You know, there's little catchy things that people do to attract attention to themselves, to be an entertainer. I dare say that ministry today is all about being an entertainer on the church stage. And dear God, I could never do that because look at how I waffle around and my speech is contemptible, to say the least, like Paul's was, or Paul's speech was contemptible and his bodily presence weak, the scripture says. Moses was a man of stumbling words, a stumbling speech. You know, but if you really read the scriptures, these are the kind of people that God uses. And it's because they're not independent of God. It's because they have been made dependent upon the Lord. And I'm a broken man. I died on my 20 years in the Army of a massive heart attack and winter survival training. I had a rubber suit on. I believe that restricted my blood flow to my brain, to my heart. I had a thrombus form in just one area, the major artery of my heart. The rest of my arteries and veins were clean as a whistle. But this is what God allowed. I told my wife that the Army doesn't own me. There's only one person that owns me, you know, the Lord God, Jesus Christ. He owns me, paid with his blood. And even though, you know, I stagger around for words, my heart is right towards the Lord. I am dependent upon the Lord, and I have been since I was a child. This is nothing unusual for me. to not fit into the world, to not be a big shot with the world. But I realize now it's because God didn't want me to. You can't serve two masters. You can't serve God and mammon both. Mammon being the world, things of the world, positions of the world, status in the world, education in the world. Whatever you put above the Lord, whatever you put above the Lord in your heart of hearts, that's what your God is. And I don't know, I'm a rough case. I nearly died drowning when I got out of the Coast Guard because I was so proud. I was a very good swimmer, and the Lord had to break me of that. And he told me, you can do nothing. And of course, that's when the lifeguards tattered together with a steel cable, pulled me out of the sea, out of the water the first time where I nearly died. So yeah, I'm a hard head. My mind, I'm ADD, ADHD. I have all these issues that the world calls them issues, learning disabilities. I was born with learning disabilities, but actually these aren't disabilities to God. These are things that God used to make me dependent upon him. These are things that he used to separate me out from the rest of the world. You see, God is building a people for himself. And these antichrists, these alternatives to Christ, the Apostle John first coined the phrase, God help me to speak, said that they started off with them, but they didn't continue. They became diverted to a different gospel. That's what an antichrist is. You ever wonder why people think the antichrist is Satan coming? Because that's how the church teaches it. But actually, it's not. It's an alternative to the Lord Jesus Christ. That's what an antichrist is. Somebody who starts off with the Lord but becomes diverted to another gospel. Now, that doesn't sound to me like once saved, always saved. That's another church trick. I'm sorry. I was raised a Calvinist, and the T.U.L.I.P doctrine is probably the best of all doctrines out there, you know, established doctrines, if you will. The established orthodoxy is probably the best, but the latter two parts of the T.U.L.I.P doctrine are wrong, because you can be given over to what you love more than the Lord. Yes, we can start off with him in initial salvation, but if we don't love him enough, we can be given over to what we put above him. And I find that most people put church above the Lord. And that's because they want to have one foot in the world and one foot in with the Lord. Well, I can tell you, somebody's been dead. Jesus Christ was pushing up next to me. I could feel him against my shoulder that day in the army. And I could see him in shadow, the robe. Yeah, I could see the robe, the hair, the beard. But more important, my spirit knew it was the Lord Jesus Christ. You know, you tell these stories to secular people, they go, well, maybe it was a relative, or maybe it was an angel. Well, the reason they say that is because they can't, this is a hard thing to explain, but I believe they can't say that it was the Lord Jesus Christ, because that means that you're right and they're not. So they have to think of something else to say what it is. You see, it's a different spirit. The church spirit is a different spirit than walking in the Lord Jesus Christ. And I never understood this. It has taken me years to understand this thing. And the reason I left the church system is because the Lord told me to follow him alone. After I had a spiritual experience with that, after I was dead, and it appeared out of the side of my eyes. I've had a lot of spiritual experiences where I can actually see things out of the side of my eyes, because it takes less light to pick up things out of the corner of your eyes than it does head on. Now, also, I'm probably spiritually sensitive in this area. A lot of people are not. But I do know that I am the Lord's, and he does speak to me personally. And don't go sharing this stuff. Like, you know, I'm very open. I share things of God with people, but I wouldn't dare do it normally. I can tell you, and I used to go in the chuuurch system, and I would try to speak some truth to God. I couldn't find the words. I even got more tongue-tied than I am doing these videos. My mind would just go blank. And the reason being is God didn't want me sharing with those people. So being the Lord's is a work that he does. It's not a work that men do. And I just want to encourage you, if you're following something other than the Lord Jesus Christ, and you know if you started with him, you have to continue with him. And, you know, I'm just going to say it straight out. My family is very church family. And that is very tragic because they all think they're going to go to heaven when they die. We're going to go home and be with the Lord. And maybe they will. I'm not their judge. I can't look at the heart. But I know one thing. If you're not with the Lord Jesus Christ now as you live and breathe in spirit, you're not going to be with him when your body packs up. You can't put God in a box. That's what churches try to do. They try to put God in a box. Because, and God won't be able to show them anything. And the reason is because they're doing it. That's why God won't be able to show them anything, because they're doing it. They're running their agenda. They're running their denomination. They're running their, according to their own natural understanding, albeit they may be educated and very well versed. Like the Dr. R.C. Sproul, I was Presbyterian, so I'll speak about that. You know, I used to listen to the radio about R.C. Sproul. He says, God doesn't speak. That's not the norm. God doesn't speak to people like this. He speaks through situations. He doesn't speak directly to them. Well, Jesus Christ or the Holy Spirit would be the teacher, and he would speak directly to you. And you know what? He speaks through situations to the unsaved, unregenerate man. So although Dr. R.C. Sproul is very well read, and I don't disagree with any of his theology, I don't see anything of the Spirit of God in him. And that's the important thing. I'm sorry, but these church systems are modern day scribes and Pharisees. That's what they are. Or entertainers, people that speak well. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. We will serve the Lord in spirit and in truth. We'll follow him as he leads, and will look only unto him, not a near lookalike, not an antichrist, which has always been misused. Good day.